Good morning, children. Welcome back to our science class. Now we are in lesson 18, Organization of Life. This is our part 3 of Organization of Life. Our video session is 26. A recapitulation. We already discussed organ system, respiratory system, mechanism of breathing, alveoli, inhalation and its exhalation. These are the topics we discussed in our previous video. Physiological process. What is meant by physiological? It is nothing but of our body functions. The ways in which biomolecules, that is cells, tissues, organs and organ system work together to accomplish the complex goal of a sustaining life. As every day, you know, we are living in this world because of what? With the help of our organs and organ system. So all the organ system, example, excretory system, circulatory system and nervous system, they are helping to sustain in this world to do our day-to-day activities. With the help of them only, we are surviving in this world. Homeostasis. What is homeostasis? See, here we have evaporation of water to regulate the body temperature. So when the body temperature increases, the evaporation, the water in our body comes out, and then the pancreas are helping to regulate the blood sugar level in our body. And then skeletal muscles, they're helping to contract and relax in the body. Blood distributes the heat, so it is spreading the heat throughout the body to maintain our body temperature. And kidneys, they are maintaining the water level in our body. If the water level is maximum, it is removing the water as a waste. And then hypothalamus, it is a behind part of our brain. It is helping to regulate the temperature and then osmotic pressure, the fluid pressure, which is fluid present in our body, blood. So it is maintaining the blood pressure level. We can call it as generally BP. Here is our heading, diffusion. Diffusion is the mixing, the concentration of the liquids. They are mixing with each other to maintain a entire concentration. It is only possible for liquids and gaseous, but also it is taking place in our body, because in our body we have a minerals, that is sodium, potassium, calcium and all. So to maintain the mineral level in our body, the diffusion is taking place. Osmosis. Osmosis is the movement of the solvent through a semi-permeable membranes into a solution of higher solute concentration that tends to equalize the concentration. For example, when the food item, this one side the salt level is maximum, the other side we don't have a salt. So what we can do, we can take a spatula to stir the food equally, then all the parts it gets a same amount of sugar. That is, the taste will be equal. Likewise, in the osmosis process in our body, it is maintaining a concentration of the minerals in the blood. So when this with the help of osmosis, they are maintaining the concentration of the blood sugar level as well as everything in our body. Types of osmosis. We have three types of osmosis. The first one is isotonic. So isotonic, what is happening in that isotonic, the external concentration of the solution is equal to the internal concentration. So outside of the water level and inside the water level, both the having concentration same. Next we have hypotonic. It's the external solution concentration is less compared to the internal concentration. So inside the water concentration is less and the outside is maximum. Then hypertonic, what is happening? The inner solution have a greater concentration, that is maximum concentration, and then the water will come out because it has heavy concentration. So in that itself the water comes out. Osmoregulation. Osmoregulation means it is maintaining the pressure in our body. So all the organisms we have extra minerals here with the help of this fish. You can see the fish is surviving both the fresh water as well as the salt water. If it is a fresh water, what is happening? The sodium chloride, because in the water itself sodium chloride is coming because some of it is salty. In the fresh water, sodium chloride level is low. So what is happening? The osmotic pressure is increasing. So very low osmotic pressure because of what? The minerals very low. So very less concentration only there. Then salt water, we have a maximum amount of sodium chloride. So for this mineral level is increasing concentration. So obviously the osmotic pressure also increasing. When the minerals are increasing, it is maintaining the body level to based on the minerals how much we are getting throughout the body. It is maintaining the concentration of our body. Osmoconformance. What is osmoconformance? It is only possible for marine organism. Marine organism means that water living animals. So these animals, they need to maintain a osmosis. So in their based on the surroundings. Even we too, when we are at a land, we feel very free because we get a sufficient amount of oxygen to breathe. But in case when we are in the water, we will not breathe properly because the oxygen level is less in water. But in that water, the fishes, other living organism in the water, they can survive easily because of what? That oxygen level is enough to them to survive, so that they can adjust themselves to survive in the water. So that their atmosphere is water, so based on the water they are adjusting themselves to maintain their body. That is a thing we can call it as osmoconformance. Osmoregulators. So osmoregulator, they are tightly regulate their body. And then salt concentration. Salt means the minerals present in our body to maintain the salt concentration in the, it is only taking place for the water animals, because water animals, they can survive the different water. So and that how much salt they are getting. So based on that salt only, it is maintaining the concentration of their body so that they are having a regulators. How much salts they are getting, based on that they are maintaining the concentration in their body. It is only applicable for the marine animals, that is water animals. Cellular respiration, it is nothing but of in our body, the cell, all the cells are gaining energy with the help of a respiration. We know the respiration process, we are taking mixture of gases, only oxygen has been taken out for our body, other remaining gases we are exhaling. So with that action, what is the work? So when we have a food, the food is broken down into glucose. Glucose is undergoing a glycolysis process, that is the energy conversion process. Here we have a glucose. This glucose is undergoing glycolysis process. Okay, in the presence of oxygen, it is taking oxygen and broken down into ATP as energy content, then carbon dioxide and water. So this is a respiration called cellular respiration. With the help of oxygen, it is taking place. Aerobic respiration, it is nothing but of the cellular respiration only. In the presence of oxygen, the glucose is undergoing a glycolysis process, then it is giving a ATP, carbon dioxide and water. In this totally reaction, we are getting 36 ATP. ATP is adenosine triphosphate. It is a energy. The food was energy converted into ATP. With the help of oxygen only, it is taking place because oxygen burning the digested food, then only it is giving energy. So we can call it as aerobic respiration. Next, anaerobic respiration. Anaerobic means in the absence of oxygen, they are not taking oxygen, and then without oxygen, the respiration is taking place. It is mainly taking place in the bacteria as well as in our muscles. Muscle part of a human body, this type of respiration is taking place. Only two molecule of ATP is converted as the energy. So it is a not a efficient process. Difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. So the aerobic is taking place in the presence of oxygen. In case of anaerobic, it's absence of oxygen. No, without oxygen, the anaerobic respiration is taking place. So it's a completely anaerobic is completely oxidizing the glucose, and then anaerobic is not a complete oxidation. In the aerobic, end of the product is carbon dioxide and water. Anaerobic respiration, ethyl alcohol, lactic acid, and carbon dioxide are the product. Here lots of energy liberated. So when the aerobic respiration taking place, 38 ATP, 38 molecules of ATP comes out. But in the anaerobic respiration, only liberating 2 ATP. When we compare, in the aerobic only we are getting a maximum energy. These aerobic respirations taking place only plants and animals. Anaerobic is occur in aerobic bacteria and then human muscle cell. Then for the aerobic respiration, glucose is with help of oxygen broken down into 6 molecule of carbon, 6 water molecule, and then 686 calories comes out energy. But in the anaerobic respiration, glucose is undergoes to ethyl alcohol, the product, carbon dioxide, and the 56 calorie only comes out from the anaerobic respiration. Metabolism. What is mean by metabolism? It is a term used to describe the chemical reaction involved in maintaining the living state of the cells. So metabolism can be conveniently divided into two categories, catabolism and then the breaking down of molecules to obtain energy. See, energy and human need. So with the help of a chemical energy, that carbohydrates, fats and other thing, the living beings gaining energy to sustain their life. Our next thing is anabolism. Anabolism is the set metabolic pathway that construction of molecule from smaller unit. It's an endocrinic process, building up aspect of the metabolism, breaking down aspect. Here also what is happening? So it is breaking down, that is, it is helping for the cell division. Then only know the living beings can grow day by day. Next we have a catabolism. Catabolism is also a metabolic pathway. It is also breaking down the molecules into smaller units. It is either oxidizing or releasing energy in the anabolic reaction. So all these things are, they are giving our energy process to our body. In that, the cells are evolving. With the help of oxygen, they are breaking down a smaller molecule as well as a bigger molecule to give us energy, that is ATP. This lesson is over. Assignment for this session: what is diffusion? What is an osmosis? Write the difference between aerobic and anaerobic respiration. What is mean by metabolism? And then what is catabolism? Thank you, children. Have a great day.